One in five Australians have been victims of sextortion, or also known as image-based abuse, according to academics and officials. It is a distressing form of blackmail, which involves the threat to distribute sexually explicit images or videos without consent of the individuals depicted, unless demands are met. Sextortion is often referred to as revenge porn. However, the key distinction lies in their intent, as revenge porn aims to harm or control individuals within relationships, whereas sextortion focuses on manipulation through explicit content.
We should be safe to live our lives how we want to. And yes, you need to consider online safety, but this is exploitation and this is abuse because it's targeted, and that's what needs to stop.
Extortion crimes have tripled, with reports skyrocketing to 8,000 this year. Although the threat affects both genders, over 90% of victims, primarily young men and teenagers, have reported falling prey to criminals impersonating attractive women. The psychological toll of having explicit images or videos sent to friends and family can be severe, with most victims affected by emotional and mental trauma.
I'm constantly worried that somebody has seen it, and even sometimes getting out of the shower, looking in the mirror, like seeing my body, it's very difficult, very triggering.
Law enforcement agencies suspect that the actual number of victims is much higher, as only a fraction of minors report extortion incidents to the police due to shame, fear, and the isolation perpetuated by abusers. Legally, each state and territory in Australia has its own legislation that addresses image-based abuse, providing further protections and penalties. The Australian Criminal Code Amendment, Intimate Images Act 2017, criminalises image-based abuse at the federal level, imposing imprisonment and significant fines for offenders. If you are a victim of image-based abuse, strengthen your case by gathering relevant evidence and report the incident to the appropriate authorities or platforms, including the Office of the eSafety Commissioner.